Hello students, this is Dr. Hemlata A, Associate Professor from Maharani Science College for Women. In this video, we shall see the social organization in primates, which includes monkeys and apes. So if you look at primates, here we are generally discussing about non-human primates. So if you look at these non-human primates, each one of them will exhibit a different type of social organization. The first type of social organization what you come across primates is solitary primates, which is seen in prosimians, which includes tarsier, bush baby and loris. These prosimians are nocturnal and arboreal primates. The males are generally solitary. They are present all by themselves and will pair with females only for the purpose of breeding. Females will be found with the infants only till the infants become independent. After that, they also live all by themselves, leading a solitary mode of life. These prosimians are shy animals. They hide themselves in the branches as a defensive mechanism. So some of the other examples what you see under solitary primates are the black-colored IAI, orangutan, which you see in Sumatra and Borneo, which are all arboreal. The males are solitary, seeking females for the purpose of mating, and the female will be present with the young one. Generally, only one young is produced at a time. So this is about the solitary primates. Then you have what is called as monogamous primates. So one example for that is the shrew, which is not a primate. If you look at the primates, you have lemurs, gibbons and hoolock gibbons. These will show the monogamous social condition. When you say monogamous, it means that they pair for lifetime. That is, one male will pair with a single female and they live together for the rest of their life. So they establish a territory which is resourceful. They will mark the territory, and in the territory they live in the form of units, where you have the unit called as the nuclear family, and they defend their territory. So in the nuclear family you will have a male, a female and the juveniles. Males generally mark the territory with the help of the urine, and they defend the territory by calling loudly and by flicking the tail so that others will not enter the territory. When some other primate tries to enter the territory, the intruders, they are attacked and chased away. Lemurs are found in Madagascar, where the male and female will live together for the lifetime and mark their territory. Tamarins are also monogamous, having nuclear families. Gibbon and hoolock gibbon are also monogamous, and they defend their territory by producing hooting calls. The next type of social organization you find is single male bisexual groups. Under this you have Hanuman langur, howler monkey, red-tailed monkey and blue monkey. This is a social group where there is a dominant male, and to this male many females are attached. These females are called as harem of females. Many females group is called as harem. When a young male tries to enter into this group, then the dominant male of this group will chase them away and protect the harem. So harem is protected by the dominant male, which is called as the overlord, and this group will be attacked by other males. So when they are attacked by other males, then they want to take the position of this overlord. So constantly there will be a fight between the overlord and males from different groups to take the dominant position. So this is about single male bisexual groups. Next you have what is called as multi-male bisexual groups. In this, the example is a baboon or papio. This is a terrestrial primate. It is found in large groups where thousands of individuals will be living together. They have several units, and in each unit there is one male attached to several female, forming a harem group, and in this group the young ones are there. So this is a small group, and these will forage together. They go out in search of food together. The male will protect the group and the herd of the female, and they will also prevent them from meeting other males. And generally in this group hierarchy is maintained. So if you see, the one group has single male and many females, and in this the strongest female will be easily accessible to the male. So the strongest female will be called as the alpha female. Alpha female will be more accessible to the male. Then the next dominant one will be the beta female. So like that, there is a hierarchy maintained in the group. So these small units where you have one male with a harem of female, like that many units will come together to form a large band, and all of them will live together and spend their time during the night time where they sleep together, so that it becomes a collective force for them to fight against any predator which will try to attack them during the night times. So by this way, the males will come together and attack a predator like a leopard. They have got the capacity to chase away the predator like a leopard because of the males coming together and trying to chase away the leopard, called as mobbing attack. Together they will create a mob and they'll try to chase away the leopard. So this is multi-male bisexual groups. Then you have, again, continuation of the multi-male bisexual groups, where you have other monkeys like rhesus monkey, where they have got large foraging units. One male is dominant and others are subordinate. In a foraging unit, you will have about 3 to 8 males, which are all bounded to 5 to 7 females. So like this, many units will form large groups where you will have hundreds of individuals which are going out for foraging, and they will defend the members together. Gorilla is another example for multi-male bisexual group. The males are terrestrial, they are very heavy, and other members can be arboreal. Females and the young ones will live on the trees, whereas the male will be on the land. They are found in groups of about 20 individuals. The old dominant males are called as silverbacks. They have silver colored fur on the back, and they are the dominant ones over all other males and females, and they maintain the hierarchy. Then you have what is called as diffused social primate groups. It is found in chimpanzees, where they form a group including about 50 individuals. Generally the females are very quiet and they are shy. They also have hierarchical ranking. Males, females will be there in the hierarchical ranking, like alpha male, beta male, alpha female, beta female. But females accept several males and there is no conflict. Means females are not binded to one male. They can mate with anybody, and when they mate, there is no fight between the males. They are omnivorous, and they hunt smaller monkeys and they share the meat. So generally they will be living on the trees, especially the region where the trees are forking. At that point they will try to rest. They go to sleep in those places. Both males and females will defend their group. The way of defense is by screaming out loudly, by gesturing, doing some postures, by throwing away objects like sticks or stones if there is an intruder trying to attack the group. So this is about the diffused social primate groups which does not form a strict social organization, and the individuals are more flexible for the purpose of mating, and you call this as diffused social primate groups. You also have a phenomenon called as polyandry, which is found in marmosets and tamarins, wherein one female will live with many males. And this association of one female with multi-male group will be characterized by cooperative breeding. So the female will breed, she will suppress the reproduction of the subordinate females. The suppression will be either by aggressive behavior or by the production of the pheromones. And when one single female is mated by more than one breeding male, you call this condition as polyandrous condition. Some or all of the individuals in these groups will participate in taking care of the offspring, and this type of social system is called as cooperative polyandry. The next one is multi-male, multi-female groups. Here you have something called as polygynandrous, means males and females, both of them are polygamous, wherein they can mate with multiple members. Both males as well as females can mate with any member of the group. So they will have multiple partners. This condition is called as polygynandrous. This forms the largest group of primates. It is a very complex social organization. There is a lot of social and kin relationships. It is seen in macaques, baboons, vervet monkeys, mangabeys, capuchins, squirrel monkeys, woolly monkeys, and some colobine monkeys, as well as lemurs like ring-tailed lemur and sifaka. In most of these species, females are philopatric and males will disperse. Means females will remain in the group and they will mate with the members of the group, whereas males can leave the group and go out and come back. So when the females are living in the native group, you call that as philopatry. So females are philopatric, whereas males will disperse. Then you have what is called as fission-fusion communities, seen in chimpanzees, bonobos, spider monkeys, and some other Attilinae monkeys. Attilinae monkeys are some new world monkey. Fission fusion communities are less cohesive. They are not binded to one another like found in earlier social communities. They will have very large home range in which temporary foraging parties will part, go away, then again come back and coalesce. Home range is an area which is resourceful and which is guarded by the members who have defined their territory. So when they have a home range, these members can become into smaller groups, go away and come back and coalesce. So this is possible because of a large home range, and it depends upon the availability of the resources as well as the reproductive condition of the female. So this is characterized by female dispersal and male philopatry. Unlike the earlier one, here the female can leave the group, go out and come back, whereas male will remain in the native group. So this is called as male philopatry found in fission fusion communities. Then you have the most complex society found in primates called as multi-level society or hierarchical society or modular society. This is found in Hamadryas baboon, Galada, snub-nosed monkey. In this society, there is three levels in the social structure. One is the one male unit, second is the band, and third is the troop or herd. One male unit is a reproductive unit where there is a single male which will be the leader, followed by many other males and several females. So one male unit where a male is the leader, followed by other males and females. Band is an ecological unit which is